Rob, W1AEX for V3ELQ. Well, signal dropped way down, went down to about an F7, but 100% copy, and the band does that, so it's gonna wander up and down a little bit. We just have to deal with it. Now, we're running the new one here, the homebrew.
At the three bander.
It's obviously on the middle band at the moment, and 350 watts carrier. It's actually about 340 at the moment, and it seems to be working okay. I got the audio gain as high as I dare. If I go any more, I think I'm going to start clipping it. I may even be clipping it slightly now. But it's a plain Jane modulator, as I reported. It's nothing. I'm not doing anything fancy. There's no peak limiter or anything like that. No pre-distortion. But I'm having a ton of fun with it. Rob, I worked a whole bunch of guys and been on in the mornings with, you know, quite a different crowd, and I'm told it sounds pretty good, so I think I'm going to pretty much leave it. I am working on another VFO for it. I don't like this VFO I got in it, and I've got another one on the bench coming along, so we're going to retrofit that, and I'm also going to work on a different pulse generator for the modulator, which is going to use a slight exponential sampling. We'll see how that works out. It will slightly compress the negatives and slightly expand the positives. I don't know if it's going to work. I got enough room in the box to put it in there in parallel with the other one. Just feed it the same audio and set the gain pots the same. And then I can switch, because it's a pulse out, I can switch the pulse. I'll put a toggle switch in there, and I can switch the pulse to the modulator output board from modulator A to modulator B, so I can do an A-B. But I haven't done that yet. I'm breadboarding that. So that's all down the pipe. But I'm just happy to have it working there, Rob. So what's it sound like? W1AEX, V3ELQ.